Is it my anger or my unfaithfulness or my selfish attitude or my arrogance at home? I will not listen to anybody. I will not study well. I will not work. What is that that I am unwilling to break? And because of my unwillingness to break myself, my family is breaking. My dear brothers and sisters, my dear fathers, my dear children in Christ, we are still in the joy of the risen Lord. And as we celebrate the third Sunday of the joy of the risen Lord, we have this beautiful incident of Emmaus. The Lord journeying with them, the Lord revealing himself to the disciples. All of us know that this year in the Archdiocese of Bangalore is declared as the year of family. And having this theme in our mind, when we look at the gospel of the day in the light of this theme, the year of family, what is the risen Lord telling us through the incident of Emmaus to each one of us, to all our families? What is the message that we are drawing from the incident of Emmaus today? We have two very inspiring things happening in the gospel. One is a beautiful prayer. Lord, stay with us, it is evening. And the other is the fruit of that prayer. And the fruit of that prayer is their eyes were opened and they recognized the Lord. A beautiful prayer. Lord, stay with us, it is evening. And the fruit of that prayer is their eyes were opened and they recognized the Lord. And as we celebrate the year of family, what is the message that Jesus is giving us today? Every family that invited Jesus, the Lord visited. Wherever Jesus was called, the Lord never rejected their invitation. The Lord willingly went. Willingly went. In the Gospel of John chapter 2, we read about the wedding at Cana. And the Gospel begins saying, Jesus and his disciples and the mother of Jesus were invited for the wedding. And Jesus was there. And the presence of Jesus changed the entire atmosphere there. Something that should have ended as a disaster with lot of shame became something glorious and a blessed one because of the presence of the Lord. And throughout the ministry of Jesus, everywhere Jesus was invited, he did go. He went to the house of Martha and Mary and explained the scriptures to them. He went to the house of Simon Peter. Mother-in-law of Simon Peter was ill, and the visitation of the Lord brings health. Where there is sickness, there is health. The visitation of the Lord changes. Jairus comes and kneels before the Lord and tells Jesus, Lord, my daughter is at the verge of dying. Come home and help us. The Lord went. A mourning place becomes a glorious place. All of them were mourning when Jesus was about to enter the house because the girl was already dead. And the presence of the Lord changes the entire atmosphere. Their tears into joy. Their hopelessness into a hopeful life. The Lord visited, or even without visitation, invitation, he himself says, Zacchaeus, come down, I must stay in your house today. And when the Lord entered the house of Zacchaeus, we know what happened. There is salvation. There is new life that is born. And the Lord says, he too is son of Abraham. And today, salvation has come. When some of the Jews come and say, there's one centurion whose servant is ill. And the Lord says, come, let us go. There was no invitation for Jesus. And Jesus says, come, let us go. And the centurion sends a word saying, I'm not worthy to have you under my roof. But the Lord was willing to go. And today, as we listen to the gospel, this is the question that the Lord is asking each of our family. How many times have we invited the Lord? Lord, stay with us. Very specially in the evenings of our life. When darkness is setting in. When we are slowly going away from the light, how many times have I called out to the Lord? And today's gospel says they pressed him to stay. They forced him, in fact. You must stay with us. And the Lord is asking us, are you willing to invite me into the evenings of your life, into the darkness of your life? And when Jesus enters our families, definitely there is a change that is going to happen. But am I willing to invite the Lord, stay with us, for it is evening. The evenings can be in the form of anything. The darkness can be setting in the form of anything. It can be in your relationship. It can be in the form of your sickness, physical, mental, spiritual. It can be in the form of your business coming down. It can be in the form of you not doing well in your studies, not able to concentrate, lot of ruptures at home, not in talking terms. In any form, that darkness can be setting in. Not able to understand each other, not able to forgive each other. Somewhere, slowly, my family is walking away from that light. And the darkness is slowly setting in. Am I willing to invite the Lord from the depths of my being? Every drop of my blood tells the Lord, Lord, stay with us, for it is evening. It is evening. I feel darkness is setting around. I want you to be the light. And Jesus says, I am the light of the world. Am I ready for that beautiful prayer? As a family, I'm inviting the Lord. Lord, stay with us, for it is evening. And when the Lord comes in, what happens to our evenings? The disciples who told the Lord, it is evening, they were afraid it is night. But in the same night, they went back. No darkness for them. When the Lord entered their journey, they were sad, looking cast down, worried, lot of questions. They felt forsaken, abandoned, desperate in the one whom we believed, now he is put to death. And all those things changes once the Lord entered, once they invited the Lord, everything changed. Am I ready to invite the Lord into the evenings of my life, into the misunderstandings of my life, into my unforgiving attitude? If we are not inviting, the Lord will not come. He is standing and knocking at the door of our heart. He will enter when we open. Either I am ready to invite the Lord, or I respond to his invitation. Come down, I must stay with you. Come down, I must stay with you in your house. And what is our response? Am I reluctant in both the ways? Neither will I invite the Lord, nor will I respond to the invitation of the Lord. If that is the case, this celebration, this Holy Mass, and all the other celebrations that we have will be empty celebrations. No outcome. The fruit of that beautiful prayer of the disciples of Emmaus, that is the second part for our family. The Lord reveals himself and he is recognized. Their eyes were opened. Their eyes were opened. You're able to see the other clearly. And they recognized the Lord. If you and I, if we are not able to recognize Jesus in our family, we will not be able to celebrate it in the church. We are not coming here to meet the Lord. We are coming here to celebrate the Lord whom we have experienced in our family. That is Mass. The disciples of Emmaus went to Jerusalem to celebrate their experience with the risen Lord. We are coming to the church to celebrate our experience. Jesus, I have experienced you in this way in my family, and I have come for the Mass today to celebrate that experience with everyone here. I bring my experience with Jesus and put it on the altar and celebrate that experience here. We are called to celebrate our experience with the Lord in the Holy Mass. And when that recognition happens, when can we really find Jesus alive in our family? It was not in the talking of Jesus, but in the breaking of Jesus they recognized. It is not in our talking that we recognize Jesus, but in our breaking. At times we talk a lot, but how much have I broken myself or my family? In that breaking, the Lord becomes alive. In the breaking of the bread, the risen Lord was seen. Even after the resurrection, when he met his disciples, he showed his breaking to them. See, I'm the one who is broken for you. Look at the wounds in my hand. Look at my side. I'm the one broken for you. It is in our breaking that we will meet the Lord. If I don't break myself, then I'm breaking my family. I'm breaking my family. We are here to celebrate that brokenness. That brokenness. And that is the memory that is celebrated here. Do this in memory of me. Do this in memory of me. And every time we break ourselves, my family is being built. My family is being built. At times we have to do things that we do not want to. Jesus never wanted to be on the cross. What was the prayer of Jesus in the Garden of Gethsemane? Lord, if it is your will, let this cup pass away from me. But then, only if I break myself, if new life is born, I am ready. None of us are willing. Breaking is not easy. That is not something that is enticing. Breaking is not interesting. Breaking is not something that gives us joy. There's a lot of pain in breaking. But then it is in that breaking the risen Lord comes alive. In the breaking of the bread, they recognized Jesus. And Jesus showed his wounds, his breaking to them, so that they could understand that he is the one broken for us. Today, which area of my life needs to be broken? Is it my anger or my unfaithfulness or my selfish attitude or my arrogance at home? I will not listen to anybody. I will not study well. I will not work. What is that I am unwilling to break? And because of my unwillingness to break myself, my family is breaking. My family is breaking because I am not able to do that sacrifice. And something very sad is, all of us can be good in the family. One person is unwilling for this sacrifice that affects the entire family. The parents cannot say, one of my child is unwilling to do this. We are not worried. The entire family is affected. The unfaithfulness of one person affects the entire family. The unforgiving attitude of one person affects the entire family. If one person does not study well, it affects the entire family. That is how the family is. If I don't do my part well, then I am breaking my family. If I am not ready to break myself, then my family is breaking. My family is breaking. Today, the Lord is asking each one of us, are you ready to break yourself? It is in the breaking that we will recognize the Lord. And the Lord whom we have recognized in our house, we have come to the church to celebrate. Today, as we offer a sacrifice now during the offertory, all your breakings, every time that you have shed tears for your family, every sacrifice that you have made, every prayers that you have offered for your children, for your loved ones in the family, every time you silently bore all that came on your way, like Jesus standing before Pilate silently, Jesus on the cross, every time you did that, you were very close to the Lord. You were very close to Jesus. And in that breaking, you're going to meet the risen Lord. Today, we are here to thank the Lord for that breaking. If you are not ready to break yourself for your family, our family cannot be united. If I am not ready to be broken for the parish cannot flourish. And today we ask the Lord, who is broken for us, to give us the grace to break ourselves for our family, for our mother church. It is in our breaking that risen Lord comes alive. And let us bring that experience with the risen Lord to celebrate when we come for the Mass.
of the darkness shining, Jesus' light of the world shine upon us. Set us free by the truth you now bring us. Shine on me. Shine on me. Shine, Jesus, shine. Fill this land with the Father's glory. Blaze, Spirit, blaze. Set our hearts on fire. Flow, river, flow. Spread the nation with grace and mercy. Send forth your love, Lord, and let there be light. Shine, Jesus, shine. Fill this land with the Father's glory. Blaze, Spirit, blaze. Set our hearts on fire. Flow, river, flow. Flood the nation with grace and mercy. Send